again. Catch the ball. Bam! Oh, don't drop it. Touch across the board, stand to the side. The next category is Sex Siren. Thank you.
Blessed is he who reads aloud the words of the prophecy, and blessed are those who hear, and who keep what is written therein, for the time is near. He is coming with the clouds, and every eye will see him, everyone who pierced him, and all the tribes of the earth will wail on account of him. Those of you who have not learned what some call the deep things of Satan, I know your works, I know your toil, and your patient endurance, and how you cannot hear evil men, but have tested those who call themselves apostles, but are not. But I have this against you, that you have abandoned the love you had.
Wanting, needing, waiting for you to justify.
And a soul beast rising out of the sea with 10 horns and 7 heads, and a blasphemous name upon its head, and the beast that I saw was like a leopard, its feet were like a bear's, and its mouth was like a lion's mouth, and to it the dragon gave his power. Men worshipped the dragon, for he had given his authority to the beast, and they worshipped the beast, saying he was like the beast and could fight against the beast. And the beast was given a mouth, uttering a haughty and blasphemous word. It was allowed to make war on the saints and to conquer them. And authority was given it over every tribe and a people and tongue and nation, and all who dwell on earth will worship it. In vain. From the throne saying, behold, the dwelling of God is with men. He will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. And God himself will be with them. He will wipe away every tear from their eyes, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain anymore. For these things will have passed away. To the thirsty I will give water without price from the fountain of the water of life. He who conquers shall have this heritage, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But as for the cowardly, the faithless, the polluted, as for the murderers, fornicators, sorcerers, idolaters, and all liars, their lot shall be in the lake that burns with fire and brimstone. And he says to me, do not seal up the words of the prophecy, for the time is near. Let the evildoers still do evil, and the filthy still be filthy, and the righteous still do right, and the holy still be holy. Behold, I am coming soon. What are you going to do?
Woo! 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 I know! Thank you. Thank you. You probably think I drink a lot of beer, huh? I don't. It's just water. Beer makes you burp. It's not good for singing. Silence. That was a joke. So, when I start the show, it's like a train that goes. And once the train starts, it doesn't stop. And there's no getting off, except two spots. One is when I was talking over there, before I left New York, and here. These are my two moments where I can share what I want to share with the audience, not through music, not through dance. First of all, I can't tell you how meaningful it is for me to come full circle, having started my career 4 decades ago, not in Brooklyn, in Manhattan, but still, just across the bridge. And here I am. I made it through the fucking wilderness. And you held my hand all the way. Well, maybe some of you like dropped it a few times, but you know, fuck you. And also, yes, we're here. That's what matters, right? We've had our ups and downs, our good, our bad, and that is life. I can't hear what you're saying, baby. My ears are poked up. This is the thing about this show. The spotlight is so bright, I can't see. I have inner ears, so I can't hear you. So it's like a sensory deprivation overload where I exude immense amounts of joy. Do you envy me? I said, do you envy me? You should, because I am the luckiest girl in the world to do what I do for this many years, to do what I do, to be strong and healthy, to be able to perform every night with my beautiful children. How fucking lucky am I? Come on, you jaded motherfuckers. I said, how fucking lucky am I, Andy? If you say one more bad thing about me on your show, you're gonna be in so much trouble. You little troublemaking queen. Oh, yeah, sure. It's that crazy kind of love. I know about it. I'm addicted to it myself. So, this past summer, you may or may not know, but I got really sick. I had some strange bacterial infection in my blood, and I almost died. And I'm not telling you this because I want you to feel sorry for me. I'm telling you this because the fact that I'm here right now is a fucking miracle. And I do not take There are some very important people in this room tonight that were with me in the hospital. There's one very important woman who dragged me to the hospital. I don't even remember. I passed out on my bathroom floor. I woke up in the ICU. And thank you, Siobhan. She saved my life. And Achan, my Kabbalah teacher, I was in an induced coma for 48 hours, and the only voice I heard was his. I heard him say, squeeze my hand. That's it. Now, maybe some of you have had this experience, I hope not. But a couple of things I thought about when I first became conscious and I saw my six incredible children sitting lobby. By the way, I had to almost die to get all my kids in one room. I know it's kind of funny, kind of not. But they were all looking pretty scared. And I couldn't understand what was going on. But the first thing that went through my head was my mother. Because my mother died of cancer and she was by herself. And I was thinking, what if I left my children? That would destroy me to leave my children at this moment in their lives. I wasn't thinking about me, I was thinking about them, but I was thinking about my mother. Like, how scared she must have been to know that she was going to leave us all behind. And you know, it takes these crazy fucking things to happen to us to make us realize what other people go through. The fear, the loneliness, the lack of support. And yes, it's true. I've lost a lot of friends, a lot of people that I love near and dear to my heart. Especially in the early 80s when AIDS swept through the city like a motherfucking windstorm and burned the city to ashes. So many beautiful artists, painters, writers, singers, beautiful, beautiful souls. So of course, you know, I pay tribute to them during the show. But it's in losing the things you love that you grow to appreciate the things that are around you, that have life, that give you life, that are full of life. And I am so grateful for all of your support over the years, through thick and thin. I don't take any of this shit for granted. I may have had a few cunty moments in the 90s where I was taking shit for granted. Don't hold it against me. Are you thinking to yourself, did she just shut up and play music? Is that what you're thinking? I'm so grateful just to stand here and talk to you. I'm so grateful. Now I'm just going to ask you to do one more thing and then we're going to get on with the show. Could you all just turn your lights on right now on your phone? Please. Andy, get it up, baby. How many times does someone say that to you at night? Put your lights up. Okay, that, wow. That's fucking beautiful. So here's what I want you to think right now, think about, keep in mind, each and every one of you in this room has the light inside of you. And the only way we are going to make a difference in the world, whether it's in this city, or in Israel, or Palestine, or wherever, is if we share our light with the world. Do you understand that? Are you with me? Okay, so I want you to keep your lights on. Keep your arms up. It's the only exercise you're going to do all night. And sing along with me if you can remember the words. First I was afraid. I was petrified. Kept thinking I could never live without you by my side. But I spent oh so many nights just thinking how you did me wrong. And I grew strong and I learned how to get along. You know the song? Go on now, go. Walk out the door. Just turn around now. 'Cause you're not welcome anymore. What you want, who tried to hurt me with goodbye. Now just make God crumble. Did you think I'd lay down and die? Did you, motherfucker? Did you? You were worried though, right? For a second. But for a second. Oh no, not I. I will survive. Cause I've got all this life to live, and I've got all this love to give, and I'll survive. I will survive.
Woo! grew up together. You've never had more fun with anyone else. I'll always love you.
Don't function anymore. forget it.